The impossible has happened. Earth is out of water. The taps are dry, the riverbeds are nothing but cracked dirt and dust, and in the city, you can hear growing sounds of riots, sirens wail, windows shatter, and fear has taken over. It's gonna be a long night, and there is not a single drop left to drink. How did this happen, and how long can the world hold out? Find out on this episode of The Infographic Show. What if the world went completely dry, minute by minute? And don't forget to subscribe. Minute 1. You're jolted out of your sleep by the sound of alarms and people shouting. It sounds like something is going on in the city. You better check the news. But first, you need to brush your teeth. You've got a serious case of morning breath. You just got to turn on the faucet and, that's weird. Nothing's coming out. It must be the plumbing. You check the kitchen sink. Same result. At least the power's still on, for now. And you've got something to drink in the fridge. You crack open a bottle of Gatorade, take a swig, and you reach for your phone. Just a quick little scroll through social media, and then you nearly spit it out. Almost. Good thing you didn't, that hydration's about to become priceless. Because across the internet, everyone is in a panic, as every source of water on the earth seems to have spontaneously vanished. Minute 2. No one knows what happened, and most never will. Across the globe, panic is setting in as people come to terms with a terrifying truth. They're going to have a ticking clock over their heads. Humans can survive only a few days without water, but for many, that countdown will be much shorter. Elsewhere, thousands are caught mid-swim in pools, lakes, and oceans when, without warning, the water vanished beneath them. What happened next depended on the depth and the position, but in many cases, the outcome is instant. A sudden drop, followed by a hard impact. Thousands are dead in seconds, and many, many more are going to find themselves headed to the not-so-briny deep. The oceans are some of the busiest transit corridors on the Earth. At any given moment, as many as 100,000 vessels are navigating the world's waters. That includes freighters, military ships, private boats, submarines, ferries, and of course, cruise ships, carrying thousands of passengers on floating vacations built for leisure. But in a world where the water suddenly disappears, none of them are safe. As the water vanishes in an instant, countless vessels and everyone aboard are pulled into chaos. Some ships find themselves stranded on dry riverbeds, their passengers dazed, waiting for a rescue that may never come. But for the larger vessels, it is far worse. Without water to hold them up, they plunge miles down, crashing into what was once the ocean floor and certain death. But that is nowhere near the biggest threat the world will face immediately. Minute 5. We are frequent guests in the seas, but that is all we are, guests. The oceans and freshwater bodies of the world are a key part of our ecosystem. It's estimated that they contain upwards of 35,000 species of fish out of over a total of 260,000 species in the ocean. This is one of the most diverse ecosystems on the Earth, and in an instant, it's about to face one of the largest mass extinctions in history. The species of the ocean are incredibly diverse, but nearly all share one crucial trait – they can't survive without water. Most fish only last a few minutes outside of their aquatic environment. We've all seen it when a goldfish flings himself out of the water and winds up gasping for air on the floor. Within minutes, the largest die-off in the history of the oceans will occur, as just about every fish species die, plus the majority of mollusk and crustacean species, and countless others. Some species like whales and dolphins won't die immediately, but it is just a matter of time. These animals are adapted to live in one place, a place that no longer exists. And it's gonna cause a cascading effect of one disaster after another. Minute 10. You can hear the rising panic from the city, and you know things are not gonna get any better out there, so you're not gonna be risking yourself by going out just yet. You lock the doors and you hunker down in front of the TV. Sure enough, there is only one thing on the television. Grim-faced news anchors trying to explain what's going on, and failing. It seems like there was some sort of apocalyptic energy wave from space that impacted the molecular bonds of the hydrogen and the oxygen, the building blocks of the water, and that caused a mass evaporation event that hit all natural bodies of water on Earth. It was instantaneous, and the only water that remained was that which was safely contained. And as for the long-term effects, well, no one is sure yet. Suddenly, the local news goes blank, and it's replaced with a grim-faced general broadcasting on every station. He urges everyone, stay calm. But a look at his own face and flop sweat makes that seem very unlikely. He explains that the government is on the case, and he urges people to stay in their homes, conserve what hydration they have, and do not go out in search of more. He states that local troops will be deputized to ensure order and prevent rioting, which has already begun in some areas as people panic. But that relies on the infrastructure staying stable, which is sketchy at best. Minute 30. Your phone is fully charged, which is good because it's not long before the power goes out. While it might not be obvious on the surface, every major power plant, hydroelectric, coal-fired, and nuclear, uses a significant amount of water to keep running. As that water dries up, the power plants will slow down and stop functioning. This won't trigger an instant global blackout like a solar storm might, but it will set off rolling blackouts that'll spread like a chain reaction, growing worse by the hour. Eventually, nearly the entire planet will go dark, and in at least one critical case, a team will have to act fast. There is nothing more terrifying than a nuclear power plant overheating, and with massive water turbines essential to cooling the reactor core, the sudden absence of water turns routine operations into a potential catastrophe. When word gets out about the sudden water shortage, the first move by the government authorities will be to contact the plants and tell them immediately to get them out of service. The rapid shutdowns will instantly knock out power to millions of people around the world, but doing that as soon as possible will possibly save lives that could have been affected by the event of a meltdown. And as the day draws on, the problems will only get worse. Hour 1. You're still safe in your home, but countless other people have decided to take their chances on the streets. As soon as word got out and the government urged people to stay calm, many people decided the exact opposite. They went out to try to find any source of water they could, and their top target was every major supermarket and big box store in the area. At first, people showed up and they tried to buy whatever they could, and then others decided, well, they'd just grab it off the shelves or from other people's carts and then make a run for it. Naturally, fights broke out. And it's time for the long arm of the law to have its say. Sheriff John Sawyer has been on the job for 32 years, but he's never seen a day like this. The town is unraveling, people are panicked, angry, desperate, and he can't blame them. Sawyer only half understands the garbled radio chatter about cosmic radiation, molecular bonds, but one thing is clear, it is hot and there is nothing to drink, and he is not feeling great. Maybe that's why he slams the thief a little too hard into the ground as he tackles him running out of the door with a bottle of Walmart brand Dr. Pepper. It's scuffed up and it can't go back on the shelf now. No one will miss it, he thinks, as he tucks it into the back of his squad car. And as the day goes on, everyone starts to feel that same ticking clock. Hour 8. The riots outside are only getting worse and the power has been flickering on and off, and you don't feel like doing much besides checking up on the apocalypse. You've been carefully conserving a few bottles of Gatorade and soda that you have in the house, but you know that you are not drinking enough. Maybe your mom was right. If you don't drink enough water, you'll get a headache and you'll make yourself sick. Because you're not feeling too good right now, so you go to lie down and doom scroll a little bit on social media. And then you find yourself Googling a key question on everyone's mind. How long can a person survive without water? Everyone is terrified that this isn't going to resolve itself in time, and humans will become yet another species on the extinction pile. The reports coming in from the oceans are unbelievably grim, but it's nothing compared to what awaits on land. The internet is giving you various answers, but they all have the same message: not long at all. Many people who die of thirst are in harsh conditions and overexerting themselves, and they can expire within 2 days. Within a safer environment with minimal physical exertion, people might be able to hold out for 5 or 6 days, but the process of death by dehydration is extremely painful, and it doesn't change the fact that everyone on Earth will be dead within a week. And so it's time to start thinking strategically. You're lucky that your refrigerator is fully stocked. The drinks you have will be a key part of your survival strategy, and you're going to ration them carefully, but also key is what foods will hydrate you and which will dehydrate you. You decide you're going to stay away from any foods that are salty or dry and avoid anything that is possibly a choking hazard like peanut butter. And on the other hand, the small amounts of fresh fruit that you have in the house, 2 apples, an orange, and some grapes, they're going to be invaluable as long as they stay fresh. Hopefully, they stay fresh as long as you do. And around the world, you are not the only one scrambling. Hour 12. As the first minutes of the water crisis dawned, countries around the world panicked, and many started saber-rattling at their closest rival. After all, when a bizarre crisis hits a country, everyone thinks it's the work of their enemy. But as soon as it became clear that there was something very different going on, and it seemed to be natural, that resulted in every country on Earth doing something they almost never do: putting aside their old rivalries and working together to figure out the next move. And they would have to move quickly. Within a matter of days before all life on Earth is extinct, it is decided to launch a massive international scavenging effort. It's believed that Earth has a significant amount of water buried in its crust and deeper in its mantle, and that water likely escaped the evaporation effect on the surface. Part of it is groundwater, which seeped into the ground from past rain and snow, and it can be found between soil particles and rock crevices. This can be harvested, but it'll require key processing to make it possible to drink. Mantle water is a more complicated question, as it is located deep underground, contained within a rock named ringwoodite that is formed under high temperature and pressure. This could be the largest possible reservoir of water on the Earth. Now we just have to get to it. Across the world, huge-scale drilling and mining efforts begin, deploying every piece of heavy machinery available. The groundwater will be the first priority to try to put some water into the system again, but it'll be nowhere near enough. Those efforts will eat up much of the limited resources left, but it was unanimously decided that there was no point in saving resources when humanity only had a few days before dehydration took us all. This multinational team will be fighting until the last bell tolls, but for everyone else, it'll just be a slow battle to survive. Hour 24. You only got a few hours of sleep last night, and you woke up feeling more tired than you did the night before. Your lips are chapped, your eyes are dry and scratchy, and you are desperate for a drink. You allow yourself a few sips of Gatorade and a grape, which alleviates the discomfort a little, but you know it's only going to get worse. You check that the doors are securely locked. Last night you heard some prowlers trying to get inside, but you think they were scared off by the police. As any form of hydration becomes more valuable than gold, the social disorder is only going to get worse. And the more time there is to think, the more unsettling a thought begins to form. What if this has happened before? You've always been a sci-fi buff, and one of the most fascinating theories that you love to read about is the idea of a past civilization on Mars. There's plenty of speculation that the strange sand and rock formations on Mars' surface are remnants of a past ocean that was wiped away, possibly by a catastrophe that eliminated Mars' atmosphere. This would have dropped the temperature massively, made it impossible for any living being on the surface to breathe, and wiped out the oceans. A once thriving civilization would have turned into a dead rock almost instantaneously. And while it won't happen that quickly, the same fate could await Earth. It's not just your dehydration that's making you feel miserable, you're pretty sure it is hotter, and that's only because the second part of the destruction of the Earth's water is coming into play. The oceans serve as a massive carbon sink, helping to cool the Earth by trapping thermal energy. Without it, greenhouse gases linger in the environment, and the temperature just keeps rising. It's estimated that in the last century, the Earth's temperature would have risen over 96.8 degrees Fahrenheit without the oceans. In reality, global warming was only able to raise it a much more modest 1.8 degrees Fahrenheit. And things are only gonna get bleaker from here. Hour 36. Humanity has only a few days left, but a lot of other organisms have much less. With no water available, agriculture will be the next pillar of human civilization to fall. Around the world, crops depend on regular watering to stay alive. This puts the majority of the world's food supply in critical danger. Within days, developing countries that have a smaller supply will start to feel the pinch. Of course, without the water needed for processing and cooking, many of the grains that are critical to life on Earth will go to waste anyway, because water isn't coming from above either. One of the oddest things about the current state of the Earth is that the clouds are fading. The sky seems brighter than ever, and the stars are more visible in the night sky. It would be beautiful if it wasn't for the fact that you know it's because the critical water cycle has been disrupted. Water evaporates from the oceans and lakes, gathers in the clouds, and then it's dumped back down on the Earth in the form of rain. A good rainstorm would be welcome right now, but you can tell it's not happening anytime soon. And soon, it may be too late. Hour 48. You've carefully been conserving your phone's battery, but it's down to around 20% now and power has become a distant memory. Honestly, you feel like you're at 20% too. The energy is gone, you've drained most of the drinks left in the house, you're not completely out of hydration yet, but it won't be long. You occasionally check on the state of the world, and it's not pretty. Riots have spread around the world, cities are in flames, and the hottest parts of the world have seen countless deaths from dehydration and overheating. And soon, the entire Earth might have bigger concerns. The Earth is primarily a water planet, or at least it was, and that affects the way it interacts with the universe. The tides have vanished, they're no longer pulled and shaped by the moon's gravity. For now, the moon remains in place, but over the long term, the absence of the Earth's water could disrupt that delicate gravitational connection. If the moon were to drift away, becoming a massive free-floating body in space, the effects could be catastrophic, altering Earth's orbit and setting off an entirely new kind of apocalypse. But Earth doesn't have to wait for that, it's already in the middle of one. You figure you might as well try to sleep. At least it'll make the apocalypse come quicker. Hour 60. But it's not going to be the usual wake-up call. You're jolted out of a fitful sleep by the sound of cheering in the streets. Not exactly a sound you would expect from what'll be the last day of life for millions of people. You rub your eyes and stick your head outside. There are troops in the street. They're broadcasting that water has been found. You're trying to listen, straining over the shouting and the cheering, and you can barely make it out. It sounds like a successful drilling mission managed to open an underground spring and it's being used to reseed key locations. But the challenges Earth is going to face now are far from over. It's only been 2.5 days since Earth's water disappeared, but the damage to the planet has been massive, and in some cases irreversible. You were lucky enough to be able to hole up at home and carefully conserve your resources, but it's still taken a massive toll on you. It'll probably take you some time to recover, especially as there is still no excess water in sight. The government is urging everyone to stay home, be cautious, and continue conserving what they have, if anything. But when the smoke clears and the water flows again, the world will look very different. The first order of business will be to transfer as much water as possible from the spring and from groundwater and place it in strategic locations to seed the clouds. Once rainwater starts falling again, the rest will take care of itself, slowly. Very slowly. The oceans will not be filled anytime soon, and that'll cause significant delays to transporting resources. For now, planes will have to be the primary method of crossing the vast expanses, which is much heavier on resources, and they can't carry the same amount of tonnage. And the toll on life is likely incalculable. The quick discovery of water after only a few days keeps the death toll from hitting the billions, but it's still gonna be in the millions. It's likely tens of thousands or more died in the immediate aftermath of the strange effect that disappeared all of the Earth's water. Many more died of dehydration and environmental conditions over the next 48 hours. But that is nothing compared to the knock-on effects caused by the devastation of Earth's food grid. A whole pillar has been knocked out instantly with the death of the oceans. The fishing industry is gone, and it may never come back. Countless species are extinct except for the samples found in captivity, and scientists will likely begin working on a project to repopulate the fish of the world via breeding and possibly cloning, but many species are lost forever. The crops will return, but Earth is in for a hard time first. The 3 days without water saw fields across the world wilt and die, and it's unlikely that the water will reach the remaining ones in time to save them. There will be seeds to replant once the water is flowing again, but this is likely to create a massive wave of starvation at the time that the current crops would have been harvested. And beyond the starvation, Earth is about to encounter an environmental disaster on a scale never seen before. Dead crops, rotting fish, and cities in ruins. The entire world might have avoided the end of the world, but it feels a lot like the post-apocalypse is here. And in the coming days, it'll be all the authorities can do to keep order. Hour 96. The digging and processing efforts have been continuing as the authorities work feverishly to provide some, if any, resources for the public. The larger water sources are being redirected toward filling empty lakes and trying to trigger rainfall, so most water being distributed is harvested from groundwater. You've been told to wait for a delivery of the first supply, and the truck passing it out is heavily guarded, just in case any rioters decide to steal the most precious thing in the world right now. It's time for your first taste of the water of the new world. And it's horrible. Brackish, mineral-tasting water directly from the ground. You force down a sip as it slides down and coats your throat, and it becomes the best water you've ever tasted. You've never realized just how important the simple substance was until it was gone. The process of rebuilding the world will likely take years, if not decades, and the mystery of how this bizarre event happened may never be solved. The only thing you know is that you can't wait for your first cup of coffee. But for now, you're gonna look at the sky waiting for that first drop of rain to fall. Earth couldn't survive long without water, but what if the power went out? Check out why a global power outage will kill you faster than World War III for all the gory details, or click on this video instead.